Alrighty, the dog's here. We're ready to go. We're drafting in the Arena Open. So thanks for checking out here on ChannelFireball.com. And oh, we got a pretty decent open. Lucamina Moondruid. It's a 3-mana Civic Wayfinder, so that's already pretty great. And then it can transform into just a bunch of ridiculous forms. Also, if it dies, it just comes back once it's transformed. So yeah, we'll be taking that one. And great start. This is the Arena Open Day 2, which means it's single a limb. And if I 3-0, I get to draft again. All right. Not passing anything even really relevant. Pilgrim's Eye, Bone Collar Cleric, whatever. All right, Lucamina Moondruid. Let's go. So let's see. What does she do? Well, let's take a look at what we've got next here first. 2-2 First Strike Reach is pretty good. But the equipment part of it is not really super relevant. There's Juvenile Mist Dragon, but I think blue is just weak enough that I'm not really looking to jump into blue, especially when there's a Grim Bounty in the pack. And Grim Bounty is fantastic. There's Prophetic Prism, Hill Giant, Herd Gorger. I think I'm just going to take Grim Bounty, though. I mean, I don't mind drafting black green. Grim Bounty is really good, and getting past a good black card is a good place to be. They took a common, it looks like. Yeah, I don't think it's Hill Giant Herd Gorger here. I think Grim Bounty is enough stronger, even though it puts me into a second color. Kind of punished here because there's no great thing. I could take Wild Shape though. The one reason to take Wild Shape is making something a turtle with hexproof is really good with Lucamina. Once you have an A+ creature, having a protection spell is pretty good. Oh, it looks like they took a white common. Well, that makes me even less likely to want to take either of these white cards. I could also just take Hobgoblin Captain, but I don't love red-green. I really want to play Lucamina. All right, let's just take Wild Chip. I don't think Fiendlash is particularly good, by the way, so I'm gonna largely be avoiding that. Oh, Undercellar Myconid. I love this one, and it lets me go in whatever direction I want. Hey, thanks for the raid, NCAA. Frequent Trophy Leader. Lulu Forgetful Holophant is his strong. Dryder's just okay. Young Blue Dragon's okay, but Myconid is really good. So getting that fourth, pretty good sign. Oh, Dreadlinorm fifth. Dreadlinorm is really good. This card's surprisingly strong. So 4-mana instant, 2+1/+1 counters, hexproof, and untap it. Is often going to get you a win a fight and leave 2+1 counters behind. And a 7-6 that basically is unblockable is really, really good. No, I haven't been too impressed with Breath Weapon. I mean, nothing else here. So, all right. Well, we're pretty much locked into green here. And we're just looking for our second color. Obviously, we have a Grim Bounty, so that's a start. Second Wild Shape. I don't really want to. I could take a Druidic Ritual. Because getting back a busted creature or like even a Dreadlinorm is good. Oh, you want 1-1 NCAA? That's unfortunate, but GG's. I don't really like Arcane Archery. Armor of Shadows is just worse than Wild Shape at this point. Hey, Stianos, welcome back with the 6 months. You know what? Maybe I just do take a second Wild Shape. I don't know. Druidic Ritual. Okay, well, now I can take a Druidic Ritual if I want. There's also a Faraday's Fireball or Unexpected Windfall or one of these blue cards. I mean, Young Blue Dragon is a good card. I might want to take it. So what is the blue version of this? Croc Form. Oh, man, it locks something down until this dies. Jeez, this card's just absurd. I think I just take Young Blue Dragon here. I don't know. We'll see where we end up. Circle of Land Druid is not my favorite. I don't love Knoll Hunter all that much, to be honest. It's just okay. There's another one here. There's also a Chardolin Dragon. I think at this point I will take the Knoll Hunter over the thing. Okay. Oh, the green gate's really good over some random other green cards. Green's very open. I'm basically just looking for whatever pulls me in a second color direction. So 2-2 First Strike Reach, but I'm just not going to have any equipment. So One in a white, 2/2 first strike reach. There's also a looter, but I think this card is pretty medium. There's also Prophetic Prism, which is pretty nice if I end up in a bunch of colors. I think I'm just going to take the Eager Scholar. I'll take the Pseudo Dragon Familiar. I don't really like the Circle of the Moon Druid all that much. And, oh wow, that's a late young blue dragon. All right. Haven't seen a single black card. Don't even consider myself locked into blue at this point. So, a bunch of wild shapes. I think I'd rather have Guild Thief. I don't know. Oh, and Arcane Archery. All right. We'll just see what we open. This card's not really anything. I'm probably just going to take Lurking Roper right now in terms of life. You know, I don't think I have any, right? Is the white version lifelink? Yeah. But that's obviously not going to help me too much. I'm still probably going to take Lurking Roper. There's just, when you play against a aggro deck, Lurking Roper is just a complete house. Okay. So now there's Viconia, Night Singer's Disciple, and this card is also busted. I might just take that. And then, I'm not saying I'm going to go back into black. This is a very splashable card. Lucamina can go get a swamp. This has a, this fixes for any color. I haven't been able to figure out how good Fraying Line is. I don't know. There's also 2 5-color fixers, but I think Viconia is just a messed up card. Oh, wow. So now we can either take Sword Coast Serpent, which is pretty solid. 2 mana bounce anything, and then 7 mana 6/6 that's sometimes unblockable. I might just take Cast Down, though. Just having a 2 mana removal spell seems way more what this deck wants. And we've increased the black splash. Also, when I look at blue, I've got 2 young blue dragons. Lucamina doesn't fix. When you cast it, you get to seek a card with a basic land type. So, I guess it's not your choice. That's funny. Contact Other Plane. I'm not taking Jan Jensen. There's Underdark Basilisk. I've been pretty unimpressed with that. There's Lantern, which I don't really like. I could just take Shambling Ghast and just be black off of... black does not seem open. I think I'm going to take Contact Other Plane here. I don't know. Okay, well, a bunch of blue cards. I guess I'll just take another Looter here. I don't think I want Lapis Orb of Dragonkind. I get to scry when I play these dragons. No, let's just take... Black is definitely open this direction, but it won't be open pack 3. Okay, so here, I guess Ettercap looks a little bit better. Ooh, plus I have Ettercap plus Pseudo Dragon Familiar, the combo. The Mondo combo. Let's take this Grim Bounty out. I'm probably just going to splash for these 2 single black cards. Still not Circle of the Land Druiding it up. At this point, I might take the Basilisk. I don't really want a second Ettercap. I don't think I can afford another Contact Other Plane. Oh, Follow the Tracks can help me fix. That seems good. Okay, this pack was okay. I got 2 really good black cards, which is obviously... I would prefer, not being in 3 colors if I have to. But this is still pretty good. I've got 2 fixing. Lucamina doesn't really count if it's Seek kind of randomly. Poison the Blade I like with, Undercellar Myconid. If I end up picking up another one of those, it also can be good with like something like this, which is just like a little value creature. And then, I have Grim Bounty, but I'm not really likely to play that. Hey, what's going on, Ark? Blue is weak. And I'm certainly not considering myself locked into blue. I'll take this. Oh, Goggles of Night is interesting. I just don't think you have time to do this card. No, I'm going to take Inspiring Bard. Oh, that's a late Air Cult Elemental. That's really good. That Air Cult Elemental is like an actual good blue card, one of very few. So getting one of 4 cards left in the pack, no one's drafting blue because no one likes drafting blue. Totally understandable. I think I'll take goggles here. I don't think the lantern is a card I'm gonna play. So if you're the only blue drafter at the table, it can be worth it sometimes. I don't know. Red and white haven't seemed open. Black was minorly open this pack, but I could have ended up with like four black cards, five black cards. So I kind of like where we're at. All right, I'll take the Orb of Dragonkind. All right, let's go. Let's go. No. Dang. Not really what I want. I don't think a lower rogue companion is good. Like, it bounces your creatures that hit them. I could take the Shadow Archdruid. I think this card is actually better. When you have this, you attack, it has Death Touch, and then it mills two, and you get to play one of those cards as long as it survives combat, which can be good with. Let's see, this gives it an extra point of toughness, I guess, is all it does. Oof, this is really, really bad. All right, I'm gonna take the Archdruid. I'm just not happy about it. Ugh, this pack's terrible too. Oh, this is not how you win all the dineros. There's Priest of Ancient Lore is the best card. I guess I could just take Druidic Ritual. Second picking Druidic Ritual is not the dream, tell you that much. I'm not super impressed with librarians. I don't know. It's probably better than Druidic Ritual, which is a sad place to be. Oh, Monster Manual. This card is quite strong. What else is in the pack? Nothing that I mean, there's a Pilgrim's Eye and a Band Together, but like you cast this and then you can just start putting gigantic creatures into play. All right, yeah, I'm gonna take Monster Manual. I think Monster Manual is great, especially if I can get some big green creatures. Emerald Dragon's not really what I had in mind. I was really thinking Hill Giant Herdgorger, but I could see the Emerald Dragon being decent here. Okay, another Archdruid, another Edercap. There's Shardolin Dragon. I don't want Summon Undead. I guess I'm not taking Dryder. I don't think Dryder is like particularly great. I think I'm just gonna take another Archdruid here. And oh, there's a Hill Giant Herdgorger. Okay, I was looking for that. That's good. I like Ray of Frost too, reasonably, but okay, I mean this is 29 cards. It's also possible that I end up. Ooh, there's a Band Together and another Follow the Tracks, but Band Together has got to be good. I have a lot of creatures, and I could use some spells here. Oh, and there's another Follow the Tracks here. I mean, there's Thrakus the Butcher, which is pretty strong, but I think taking another Follow the Tracks is probably where I want to be if I'm gonna play three colors here. I'm not gonna get any Pilgrim's Eyes at this point. Take out a Wild Shape. Probably take out a Pseudo Dragon Familiar, Arcane Archery. So, what does Blur do for me? It doesn't really do a lot. It's good with Aircold Elemental. I guess it's kind of good with Inspiring Bard or Lurking Roper. I mean, I think I'd rather take Charm Sleep, but Charm Sleep is pretty weak, so I don't know. Could be Mono Green with two splashes. We potentially could. Like, if I took out. Yeah, I guess I could take out, like, basically splash a couple of these good blue cards. I think at that point I'd play Druidic Ritual. I mean, Grim Bounty could be getting in. Oh, another Band Together. Okay. Green was really open. I think, oh, another contact, other player. I don't think I want Circle of the Moon Druid, right? No, I don't. How many creatures do I have? 16. Let's just take contact other plane. Oh, and then another Edder Capture. Okay, with two Edder Caps, if I play both, I might want the oh, that's a late Jade Orb of Dragonkind. I've actually found the Jade one to be pretty good against removal spells. Okay, let's see what we got here. So if we take a these. Well, I guess there's no world where we don't play those four black cards. As usual, blue is just still not good. I mean, look, Young Blue Dragon and Air Cold Elemental are both fine, and these blue cards are okay. So the question is, what would I want to cut to play this? I guess Druidic Ritual and with the double Archdruid is pretty good. I mean, Null Wild Shape is just okay with the Archdruid. Jade Orb of Dragonkind I can probably pass on. Poison the Blade hasn't ended up looking great here. So the question is, do I want to play Grim Bounty and then splash a couple Young Blue Dragons? Do I want to just play Grim Bounty and then play some green cards or green and black cards only? Yeah, I think I mean, the other thing is it's not like Follow the Tracks. So Follow the Tracks goes and gets any of these gates of your choice. So it's basically a Rampant Growth for any color, because I can just get like a black or a blue gate. And then later it draws you a card. I have basically three extra blue sources off of the two Follow the Tracks and the Myconid. And then, I mean, Lucamina doesn't really count for much if I'm playing like an island. And this is how many creatures? It's just 13. I guess what I would want to do is I would want to play Inspiring Bard. I would really like another creature. No, Roper is good. You are underestimating Roper. 3-mana, 4/5 wall is still pretty good. I'm just deciding if it's worth, especially with like, And this deck has what? I've got Inspiring Bard can untap it by gaining 3 life, and Viconia can by using the black version to drain them for 2. And then I guess Lucamina can't. I mean, I like playing Druidic Ritual with Lucamina. I have a lot of ways to get back. Oh yeah, Dreadlinner untaps it, so. I have 2 dragons. Yeah, I'm not into Jade Orbit that much here. What I think I might do is, what if I splash the 2 Young Blue Dragons? Oh, man, I really want to get that Air Cult Elemental in there, but I don't really see how I do that. So, because I can splash those off like one island and then the 2 Follow the Tracks. Because I think I want an island so I can activate the blue gate, because you do need blue mana. Double blue is tough. There's also a Contact Other Plane. But I don't think that's what I'm in for. No, I need to cut a card if I do this. I probably cut an Ettercap at this point. What is the blue Viconia? I've never done that. Oh, wow. You get a creature and a spell back? Huh, okay. Well, that's pretty good. And maybe I play like 2 islands, just to make it a little more likely Lucamina and Viconia can do these things. All right, so I get, wait, this is 8. This is, I'm 1 land short. So let's, I think this is where I'm at. Oh no, I'm not playing 16 lands. I don't think you should basically ever play 16 lands on this format, or very rarely. You have a lot of ways to use your mana. Nine green, and then 6, basically 7, 8, 9 black, and 2, 3, 4, 5 blue. I know that Follow the Tracks can't fix 2 colors at the same time, but winning 3 with this looks tough. I don't know. I've got a couple bombs and a couple of removal spells. I feel like it's pretty good. So what's the best card that I'm not playing? I guess the best card I'm not playing is Air Cult Elemental, but I think I probably shouldn't. Though I do have this monster manual. This ends up with 15 creatures, which is a little better, I think. And then, I'm not playing like some of these blue card draw. What is the green one on this? Seek 2 creatures. I have just mostly been unimpressed with Vol. Low volume. Okay. I mean, Null Hunter's a little weak here, but I think it's okay. I guess I could, if I wanted to, instead of Null Hunter, I guess I could play. I don't really want to play a trick. I'd kind of want to play a creature. Would it be another Ettercap? Nah, at that point, Null Hunter's probably good. Yes, Sam, it's a specialized card that isn't busted. All right. Nope, no delays, no delays. All right, Wilhelm. Let's see what we got. Well, I'm gonna keep this hand. Really hope they don't play a two drop, and I hope I draw a third land. So, yeah, I'm not loving it, but I don't think you can mulligan this hand. This is best of three. Oh, they mulliganed. Okay, that makes it a little better. Hopefully, they're not red or white. We want to play against something a little slower. Okay, blue. And I drew a land. All right. Both those. The fact that they mulliganed to played an island and I drew a land makes me feel a little better about all this. Yeah, young blue dragon, that's fine. I would rather not have them play an aggressive two drop. Yeah, I can fix that. Well, I didn't. Well, I drew all lands and then they played a Soul Knife Spy, so I'm not really happy about that. I need to stop drawing lands. They got a card out of that, so they unmulliganed, and I'm probably going to have to Grim Bounty that, which I hate doing. Oh my god. Yeah, you know, I don't like it, but I'm just gonna have to trade. I don't think I can just give them extra cards over and over again. I mean, if they kill Viconia, that's unfortunate. But if they don't kill Viconia, I will just block. Oh man. On the play, double Soul Knife Spy against a slow draw. Okay. So this dude can't be blocked. Exile, specialize five. There are two instants and sorceries now. And then the blue one. Let's see. Guess I'm gonna scry one and draw. It's a way to start. Could have used this earlier. At this point, I think it's too late. You know what? I really don't like it, but I don't think I can afford to Grim Bounty a Soul Knife Spy. I have to just play a blocker and hope it works. Yeah. Because if I Grim Bounty the 3/2, I just lose to this card or one of these dragons. Yeah, I mean, Soul Knife Spy basically doesn't do this in this format very often, but you know, when it does, it's good. I gotta hand it to him. Yeah, I don't really even want to show them anything else. I can't really conceive of a way where we win this game. All right. Well, I guess I like Null Hunter. So I will keep those. And I'll put another Ettercap in for sure. And I think I might take out Druidic Ritual given this. All right. All right, I will play first. I'm gonna keep this hand, but Yeah, unfortunate. Okay, well, that's actually a pretty good one. Yeah, we'll take the Myconid. Getting a th th this into dragon is pretty good. Okay, Viconia is good too. So they're not gonna be able to do much with this for a while. I mean, now obviously they get to attack me for two. I also got framed in one today, squirrel. Let's just go ahead and play the dragon. Pass. They have two specialized creatures, and I only have one band together, but you know, what can you do? I guess this one just doesn't seem that great right now, so I'm probably most interested in killing their Viconia. Yeah. Non-legendary, very nice. Let's go Viconia. I think I want to turn it into plus two versus drain them for two. So I guess I'd rather do that. And let's band together. It was Armor of Shadows was the trick they had. I guess I'll pass. I guess I need a Grim Bounty or another band together to kill Viconia. Though, don't know. My Viconia kind of cancels theirs out to some degree. I guess I should have just exiled the dragon on my turn now that I think about it. Because now, yeah, now I can't stop them from exiling it. Well, I could exile in response, but they could just do it again. It's not a sorcery. Let's let's read the cards here, which I should, you know, obviously should have made the different play on my turn, but that's not a reason to double down with another misplay. Yeah, the way this is working out is not well for me. Should have exiled their instant response. No, that still doesn't work. Okay. Right, so they get those in their hand. End of turn. And exile Grim Bounty. They're gonna exile it. And man, I don't even know. More lands, huh? Discard this. Play this. Hill Giant Herd Gorger, huh? Yeah, that's probably fine. Unfortunately, when this attacks, And if I double team with it, I don't get a 4/6. I get a 2/4, which is kind of sad because it's like the whole point of digital is to like do those cool things. But there you are. I mean, they can band together and kill my Viconia and cast a young blue dragon scry if they want, but it's not the end of the world. Sure. They've just played three legends so far. Classic. I mean, I'm going to get to cast down a young blue dragon at some point, but they have one spell in the graveyard. All right, I'll just pass. I'm going to make sure they don't have two spells in the graveyard for so this can't so this can't go off easily. So I mean, I guess if they just tap out to play a blue dragon, if that's their best play, I'm not doing too bad at that point. Okay, get the Armor of Shadows. Blue Dragon is indeed cast downable. So I don't really need to do it before blocks, and I'm not attacking with Viconia, so, and I don't think anything I could do right now would change my attacks here, so let's just do this. I'm really hoping they go for the band together. Oh, they're doing this. Okay. Well, I'm going to go for a cast down here. Ooh, they don't have anything? Okay. We take those. I don't think... I'm just gonna do this. We'll take Monster Manual. Okay. And we'll wait on Viconia, I guess. We don't need to do anything right now. I did not expect that block either, but all right. Turns out Viconia's busted. Getting a 4/6 Lizardfolk Librarians was a pretty big game. Whew, okay. Well, I'm not taking Cast Down out of my deck, but I thought we were dead many times at that point. Should I, maybe at this point on the draw, I should take out Emerald Dragon for a wild shape to stop Grim Bounty. Will there be a showdown with Lords for Baldur's Gate? I don't know. None of us seem to really be too interested in that. And maybe I take out a Follow the Tracks for something. Maybe I just want the Emerald Dragon instead. Mm-hmm. Archeries are good. No, I'm going to disagree with that. Maybe I just want two wild shapes. I don't know. They seem to have a decent amount of removal. Let's not get run over by Soulblade dudes again. Please. I mean, I have to keep this hand. Turn three, Lucamina. Yeah. They mulliganed. Hey, Devogred, welcome. Would Monster Manual be better if it was a different card? Well, I don't know. I think Monster Manual is a reasonable card. No. Okay, that's fine. I accept that because that's not, you know, them playing Like the 2-1 unblockable. Oh my god, they're gonna play the stupid. Okay, they played that. That I can at least accept. Oh, interesting. No, I guess I don't want to do that with that in place. Let's just play this. Hope to seek a swamp. So I can Grim Bounty Viconia. Hey, Destructotron, welcome. Okay, well, the good thing about that is it actually means that they can't Viconia, like, Viconia doesn't really do much there. Though I suppose Viconia doesn't do that much, just in general here. Don't have Armor of Shadows. Oh, thank you. Whoa, they didn't exile my thing? Huh. Weird. Okay. Ooh, baby. Hold on. Yeah, I guess I'm going to Monster Manual first. I'll take Inspiring Bard. And then I'm going to do this. Okay. I mean, I could have taken the Basilisk, I guess, because of these, but Inspiring Bard's big enough to do that most of the time. Okay, I'm kind of liking how this is going. Monster Manual. I mean, part of it is this is a 4-mana card and this is a 2-mana card. And Monster Manual makes all my creatures 2-mana cards, kind of, so. They just run out the Illithid Harvester. Okay. It's fine with me. I'm going to go Monster Manual, and they've already used a Sewer Plague. They haven't used a Grim Bounty. No, let's just do this. Yes, I could Lenormand. This is not really a combo with Adventure, which is kind of funny, because if I could put the Ettercap into play, I would have, but I still think it's fine to do it this way. Oh, they have the undersimplify? The mana leak? Yeah, they do. Yeah, I'll pay 2 for a 0/5 reach. That's fine. 0/5 reach draw card for 2 mana, effectively. This blocks their Illithid Harvester. Could block their young dragon or young blue dragons. Okay, they're gonna take it, sure. Let's go ahead and just Monster Manual in the Archdruid. No, Alan, it's not that I'm confused by the perpetual modified cards. It's that I think that they missed a good opportunity with them. It's like, why wouldn't you make it so when you perpetually modify a double team attack, get another double team, that you get to keep the bonuses? Like, that just makes the card cooler. Like, that's the whole point of the digital design. It is a very weird design decision. Yes, this is Sorcery Speed. They're going to have to use Grim Bounty if they have it pretty soon here. Yeah. I guess I just do this. If they have a second kill spell, they get to get rid of my Dreadlord Worm as well. But if they don't, they're just completely done. Okay, they get to make an unblockable with Cradle to Grave. But I don't think they're going to win this. Let's go ahead and mill a forest and a Knoll Hunter. Yeah, they're pretty donezo, I would say. And I'm at 13. I just pass. I, I, I could band together, but I think I'd rather make them pay to make it unblockable if that's what they want to do first. Vampire spawn, sure. Bard, Null Hunter there. Okay. Boom. 1-0. All right. Did not think we were winning game two. We're 1-0. So we've locked up. What did we lock up? 2,500 gems. All right. Let me just take a look here. God, maybe these maybe the second fall of the tracks is not what I want. Maybe I'm going to cut one fall of the tracks for a wild shape. All right. It's day two of the Arena Open. You're single a limb. One match loss and you're done. So let's hope to not get a match loss. Hey, GG's Wilhelm. Close games. I thought I was done for game two. You're heading to Oakland to go hiking today. Where should you grab coffee? I mean, honestly, like Pete's is one of my favorite coffee shops in Oakland. So I would just say Pete's. It's a chain. They've actually kind of spread around the country, but I really like Pete's. P-E-E-T. Not the more traditionally spelled. Oh no. Do I have like? Am I locked? Hold on. Let me see. Hopefully I'm not frozen here. Okay. I don't know what was happening there, but I didn't like it. Because I wasn't in queue because that wasn't a wait time because I couldn't cancel out of it. So I think I'd already gotten paired. But I don't know. We'll see. Yeah, like right here. Pack one was Lucamina. That's really funny. Sam, that's amazing. Okay. All right, well, we have a cast down for early play, and then if they don't play anything, I just play young Jeezy here. Oh, well, I'm not going to cast down that, I don't think. So let's just go ahead and we'll take a forest here. I don't think we can. Unfortunately, Guildsworn Prowler is really good, but looks like they're on all black mana. All right. I guess that's fine, too. We accept the mana screw games. No! We had the dream. Well, they didn't have a way to kill it immediately. Minimus containment, I don't really care. I'm definitely not blocking here. All right. So they're playing three colors. To play this, and let's just play the young blue dragon. How could this go wrong? They must have all red cards and they're splashing white. So they got pretty punished given that it's turn five and they've cast, turn six now, and they've cast one card. Obviously they're gonna play the Hourglass Coven here. Desi, you never can give up value. This doesn't draw a card on blocking. It says it on the card. How could you possibly give up value? Instead, they'll let me attack with my Ophidian over and over again. Kalain is the start. I don't think that's going to be... Okay, sure. Mm-hmm. Let's see. No, I don't think. How do I want to do this? Wait, no. Oh man, I missed on those things. That's unfortunate. This has death touch, right? Why not delay? I don't like streaming on delay because interacting with most of the non-squirrels in chat is pretty worth it. But yeah, they're black. They're just black red, and they're like splashing a white card or something. Yes, I almost did that play without having death touch, but I'm not that far gone. We're not there yet. Wow, this Guildsworn Prowler just won't quit. I'm going to lose game 2 to Lazale. Yeah, probably. Oh, Druidic Ritual with this. Let's see, they have a 4-3. Just taking it? Wow. This is aggressive. I'm at 10. I mean, I'm going to cast down the Goblin almost for sure. So would I rather have an Inspiring Bard or a Null Hunter? I think I'd rather just do this. Gain 3. Pass the turn. And if they go to combat, I just kill the Battlecry Goblin, I think. Yeah, I guess the opponent is as real as the streets here. Against red-black, potentially aggressive. Obviously, Battlecry Goblin's the nuts no matter what. Do I want... I haven't seen any removal. I might take out a Wild Shape and an Edder Cap and maybe try to... Let's see if there's anything else good. All right, I'll block here. I have so much card advantage, I don't really need to take a bunch of extra damage. Must attack if able. No. Oh, I think Guildsworn Prowler is a fantastic card. I love the card itself. I think my opponent probably should have bit the bullet and just done this trade a while ago. It's going to be tough if that's their play. Discard Emerald Dragon. Put a Battlecry Goblin in hand. Battlecry Goblin. Oh, I can't give it haste. Well, that's fine. Play a land, pass, I guess. This is still a 4-4. The thing is, the double team doesn't work that well either, because I can get a double teamed off this, but I can't cast it anyway, so I think just a 2-mana 4-4 is probably pretty good. Grim Bounty, my Battlecry Goblin. I think Andrew's theory that it's Lazale that they're splashing. All right. I think Ettercap and Wild Shape are looking a little bit less good. Is it possible? Does blue give me... Blue is not really known for its, like, low drops, so I guess I can't really speed myself up by playing blue, can I? It was a strange one. Like, If I wanted to cut Grim Bounty and add a couple more blue cards, would that be good? I'm playing every cheap card I have. Maybe I do keep the wild shape, but maybe I just play two. Don't love that. Maybe I don't sideboard. Maybe I just keep the Edder Cap. Man, people really love these librarians. I don't get it. A card is just fine. I'm not really looking to splash for it. Yeah, I guess I'd rather have a wild shape than an Edder Cap against what I've seen. All right. Come on. Undercell or Myconid. Okay. Oh, Null Hunter. That actually plays. Because I can go this on two, follow the tracks on three. I'm snapping off the block here. This is match number two. You have to win four matches to get money. I don't like it. They're going to get to sack the Guildsworn Prowler and draw a card, but they're getting a card out of Guildsworn Prowler regardless, and unfortunately it might mean that they make their land drop here. Oh my god. Well, let's follow the tracks. Let's get a black gate here. Then we're going to play Kog'Maw. This is not going to do it. Here, actually, I wouldn't hate drawing Wild Shape. Actually, think as sad as it is, I just have to play this. I don't think I can even play the Archdruid here because it just doesn't block anything. Okay. I mean, because this at least blocks the Jaded Sellsword. Okay, that's not so bad. I'm gonna go 10 here. And I think I just. Boom. I mean, if they had Grim Bounty, I feel like they would have cast it last turn. Obviously, famous last words, but if they don't have something here, it's not like I'm giving up all of this adventure value. I've cast three adventure cards without playing the other half, but I just need to not die. And I've got like two gates, I've got Kaga, I've got ways to get a lot of value. Oh, they're gating? Okay. Lotus Petal this turn, but next turn it's going to generate some mana too. Ooh. Is that good? They get. You know what? I think I'm just gonna do this. Wow, the way it tapped my mana was not how I wanted it to do it. The reason I didn't Grim Bounty is. The ghouls are just I wouldn't get a treasure first of all, but more than that, like I don't know, the ghouls are just not. Oh, they didn't have a creature in hand to give haste to. I do like that too. I'm still in a spot where if they found a Grim Bounty, I'm pretty screwed, but I don't know. Killing a 2/2 ghoul, which I know it could be a 4/4, but it's not really a 4. They don't have tons of fodder right now. Feels like if they play like a Gnoll Hunting Party, I'll be a lot more inclined to do that. You think they're bluffing not having a creature? Yeah, that could have been true, but that's obviously pretty punishing for very low value. Well, they could have lands. They haven't missed a land drop yet, I don't think. Because I remember I accelerated one out. Hmm. Okay, 2/2 double team first strike. Why are they attacking with this ghoul? This doesn't make any sense. I kind of wish I had used Grim Bounty now that they play that card, but. They're just throwing away this for two extra damage. But they shouldn't really want to sack this here, I don't think. I don't know. It's kind of weird. Unless they have, like. I mean, we'll see. A deal two or a plus three or something. A manticore, sure, yeah, that could be it. Because now they're going to sack this to there. Is that the joke? Okay, I mean, I like where. No, they clearly have something to make this improvised weaponry, sure. Okay, I'm in for all of this. Oh, band together was really good. All right, so nice lurking roper, double strike spell wrist. Yeah, you can't do anything about that. Let's see. I guess I go roper past the turn. I mean, this is close. Mole hunting party, sure. Oh, this had haste. Okay, well, that was a mistake. I'm gonna have to deal with a second mole hunting party, which I think I'll be able to, but clearly I should not have done it that way. They didn't even sack it? Okay. Well, I gave them a free Knoll hunting party, which I don't like. But otherwise, I feel pretty good. You could use an Inspiring Bard. Oh, or a Hill Giant Herd Gorger. Yes, we're doing that. Now, of course, I wish I'd attacked with a Lurking Roper, but yes, the Conjured Copy doesn't have haste. That I do know. Okay, sure. Undercellar Myconid Grim Bounty. So let's. This doesn't have first strike. I guess I'm fine with the Archdruid trading for either of these things. So let's go like this. I've got to start getting them. Oh, there's the Inspiring Bard. Man, this Lurking Roper could have really just been getting in there. Oh, actually, I should have tapped this differently. I think. Because I'm going to do this. Yeah, I'll mill. Okay, I want a swamp. And I want a dread linorm. Then I'm just going to put a dread linorm into play. There we go. There we go. Okay. There we go. 2-0. This deck is not a 2-0 deck, but we're doing our best. All right. Monster Manual has been good. I will say that. I think if this deck had two more two drops, then I would be a lot happier with it. My biggest vulnerability is I've got Knoll Hunter, Underdark Basilisk, Cast Down Viconia as my early plays, and I would really like another play. Okay, if we win this match, we get to draft again. Huge sweat. Huge sweat. I'm on the draw. Not a good sign. Okay, I'm in for this. This is a good hand. Obviously, if I was on the play, I'd be a little happier. I like playing against green though. Playing against green is good for me, I think. I think my deck's pretty good against green decks. I'm gonna you line up the shot. They're cycling it to draw a card. Sure. The way the day two of the Arena Open works. Oh, no plays. Yeah, I'm just gonna kill that. Cause I'm gonna spend my mana the next bunch of turns here. Oh. Yeah, I should still just play that first, I think. Is if you 3-0 your first draft, you get to draft again, and then that's where the real prize starts. So they missed a land drop and then they hit and then all right, well we got the one turn. Guess I can't complain too much about that. Follow the tracks for to C Tower. It just means now when they play a land this turn too, they're just gonna have, yeah. Now we know they have five spells in hand. But okay, well a second Myconid is a little weaker than the first one. With five mana, their best player is a yeah, I don't care about that too much either. Okay. Let's start getting this monster manual going. Okay, let's get Viconia. And let's just play the monster manual. I feel like playing the monster manual is good because it uses my mana more efficiently. It's not like I care about attacking with Viconia next turn, and playing and specializing this right away can give me a lot more value. I probably just exile the young blue dragon. And just discard the forest or something. Yeah, they have a bunch of ramp. No, now I'm actually pretty happy they've drawn all these lands. Their hand doesn't do much. Oh, they actually can get a counter on their Knoll Hunter, funnily enough. Not that I'm overly concerned about that. Yes, if we can get an island and get cast down back, that would be sick. Death Sea? Thank you very much, my friend. Your efforts are always appreciated. They can't even have cast down, like, nothing can kill this for the mana they have, I don't think. Young Jeezy. Now I get a cast down and a young blue dragon and effectively in hand. Well, no, just actually in my hand. And then I think I'm just gonna monster manual. This Emerald Dragon into play. And then if they want to cast down my Emerald Dragon, it kind of feels like that's what they have, but you know, if they do, then they do. I'm at 14, I can take another hit here. And if they don't have it, they're in a lot of trouble. So what was how much did this cost 6 mana? Yeah, 6 mana. Discard an island, make a 3/4 that draws a young blue dragon and a cast down, which is, yeah, pretty much near infinite value. Sure. And then they get to sack a token to give this a +1/+1 counter effectively, because they attack with those two plus like a token or whatever. I guess they can attack with all three. Sure. I'm probably just since I want to preserve my life total a bit, just blocking the token. Because if I block this, they get another token. Oh, Deadly Dispute, sure. I guess that's what they had. All right. I'm gonna take some damage here, but I feel like I'm doing okay. Because I have cast down for the Knoll Hunter. I have a blue dragon to block. Shadow Archdruid. Yeah, actually, why don't I do this? Take action. Okay, I want Emerald Dragon and Island, I guess. Then I can play this. And I can play Knoll Hunter. I think I'm just going to play the Forest. And then the Emerald Dragon. I'm not going to attack. I might chump the Knoll Hunter. I want to block the Myconids. I just hope they don't have another removal spell. Because if they do have another removal spell, we're getting a little bit into dangerous territory. Monster Manual has been really good for me so far. This Knoll Hunter has been causing me problems. I will say that. The second removal spell could be pretty tough here. But they're not slamming it. Okay. Oh, they're just doing that. I'll just block there. I don't want to give up the Shadow Archdruid. I think the Shadow Archdruid is going to be really good here. Okay. Now I'm feeling pretty good about this, because next turn I have enough mana now. I've been hitting all my land drops. I get to scry and cast it, and then if I scry into something for Monster Manual, that would be pretty good. Draconic Muralist. So they do get to go get a dragon. Oh, I do like that. Yeah, let's go ahead and attack with the Archdruid first, I think. I'd rather do this than mill first. Mm-hmm. Another young blue dragon. Nice. I think I have enough good stuff here that if they just block with the Muralist, I let them trade. I could also cast down the Muralists here. I don't think I need to do that. Hopefully I don't get a legendary dragon. But most of the dragons of this set are not legendary. Oh, they're going to get another one of those? Sure, that's fine. Alright, I'm not too worried about that. Okay, so now... Oh, wait, I forgot this has to live through combat to get to thing. Oh. Okay, that was a bit of an error then. I should have cast the cast down there. But whatever. I don't like how it tapped my mana at all. I mean, I guess it doesn't matter, but... Mm-hmm. All right. Yeah, so basically I guess I should have cast down so I could cast the young blue dragon. That was unfortunate. Hey, what's up, Louis? So I played the island because I have the gate to Sea Tower, but now that I'm thinking about it, I maybe should have not done that because I have Lucamina, and I think the blue version's better, but... All right. Well, still feeling pretty good about this situation. They have a lot of cards in hand. They've now stopped hitting land drops, which again, like that's, you know, what they missed turn two, then they hit all the way to five and then stopped, which is like pretty close to ideal, obviously. But they've also not been doing stuff that's like super dangerous, so. I mean, I guess if they kill my young blue dragon now, they're going to play that. All right, I can't cast down that, but... that's actually not that good against Viconia, though, Because they attack with this, they mill two. I get to exile them before they have a chance to cast them. Okay, well, I'm going to exile Draconic Muralists. Mm-hmm. Band together is nice. Okay. Let's see. Four. Yeah, I have enough mana that I can gate to Sea Tower and still. Oh, okay. So, if I cast it, I get to seek. I'm at 9, they're at 20. I have 12 cards in deck. I'm doing fine on that. They haven't played any removal. Yeah, I think I just play this. Seek, and I think I'd rather 4/4 trample. You look at your trample versus has to be blocked. Death touch. I think I'd rather keep the option for the green one up more. I'm just gonna keep all my removal spells up. This does put this vulnerable to removal for a turn. But I feel like I'm doing pretty well, even if they have a removal spell. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to keep mana up for my removal, my own removal. If they attack with the Draconic Muralists, I'm probably just chomping with the Myconid. Okay, if they're going to attack with that, they can't get too aggressive here. The black one wins right away. Well, not quite. They milled Armor of Shadows and band together. So they didn't even actually mill anything that they can play this turn. So I think I'm just gonna take one. Okay. That's acceptable. I think I'm just gonna cast down on that. Spend my mana. You don't have to block it with all creatures now. They don't really do that very often anymore. So. And then. Yeah, let's just make this into a trampler. And they're at 16. Other creatures have trample. So if I attack with this, they block with the Muralist, and then it just comes back. Okay. And right now, this is 16 damage. But if they chump. So if this blocks there, and then Myconid blocks there, I guess I could attack with my Myconid, and then they have to block with both Myconids. And they have to block there. Yeah, I think I just do this. No, they're not dead on board. This doesn't have trample. But other creatures. Oh, this also has trample. Never mind, they're just dead then. I only read the top card. See, there's a paragraph before the trample, so. So currently I'm attacking them with 22 power tramples. They have to block with 6 toughness, which means they have to block with everything but the imp, assuming I don't have band together. Of course I do. But. Hmm. And then I can even put this into play with Monster Manual afterwards. Let's see if they'll show me their dragon they get. No, that was the Van Together from Viconia. All right, so Wild Shape didn't actually look that good there. They were like kind of the same deck as us. Ettercap didn't, I mean, they have the Nefarious Imp and they have some ways to get dragons, so Ettercap might actually be good. But what I kind of want to do, is there a way to go a little higher on blue? One less black. One more follow the tracks. Air Cult Elemental. And like a contact other plane. Hey, Bento Box Out. Welcome back. Welcome back. Maybe take out Lurking Roper. Maybe just go down to four. Like, this is running a little low on swamps, but I think that might be okay. Maybe, no, you know what? Maybe I still just play one more swamp, one less, eight green sources. No, I know. I need to do it this way. And yeah, I mean, it's also possible that I do the double Ettercap Pseudo Dragon familiar thing. At that point, I probably take out a Gnoll Hunter and Inspiring Bard. And then I maybe just don't run the contact other plane. Man, I kind of like it here. Other thing I could do is I could take out Grim Bounty because I'm adding in a bunch of removal options, contact other plane, then I can go three swamps. Their deck did not seem aggressive to me. Actually, you know what? Instead of contact other plan, I'm going to put in a Vol. I don't know. We'll see. Why is Pseudo Dragon actually a dragon? It's kind of like Dragon Kin, which I guess count as dragons. I don't know. Could use an Underarch Basilisk here. Oh, that's actually not so bad. I'm gonna take a little damage. Okay, oh. Interesting, interesting. So the problem is Lucamina can't specialize until turn six anyway. And I'm not blocking the Guildsworn Prowler, so I think I'm just going to do this. Okay, I guess I'll take Yellow Blue Dragon. Milled Cast Down. And, well, I don't mind milling all the follow tracks. And I guess I can't even cast down right now, so... If they don't have a play this turn, which I mean, I'm sure they're going to play like the 4-3 dragon guy, then I'd be feeling pretty good. Oh, is that their play this turn? Okay. Okay. If they can't kill Monster Manual, I'm feeling pretty good about this. I mean, it's pretty hard to kill Monster Manual, but they could have that specialized green creature. I'm going to 11 here, but it's really not that bad. So how could they have both those two cards in their hand? What happened there? I guess I don't get it. Just gonna put a Dread Linorm into play. And then pass with band together. They drew the 1/1, but yes, they would have cast the 2/2. Like, that's what I don't understand. Oh, that's unfortunate. Okay. They thought I had counter spells in hand? No, I was tapped out. I tapped out on turn 3 to cast Monster Manual, and then tapped out on turn... Well, Zoological Study, then tapped out on turn 4 to cast Monster Manual. I guess they left Grave Choice up. They probably just had Shambling Ghast, and they're like, well, I'll just leave a 3-mana spell up instead of playing a 1/1. Sure. Okay, this is going to be a lot. Okay. What to do here? I'm definitely going to put the Air Cult Elemental into play. I have 6 mana, 3. I could play Lucamina. I guess playing Lucamina means I don't die, right? I put Air Cult Elemental in play, Lucamina blocks. I don't love the spot I'm in, but... And nothing... Oh wait, I have a blue card, hold on. You know what I could do is I could actually just cast... I think I cast Lucamina... Three, yeah, no, I think actually. Do this. And. I mean, if they draw removal, I'm dead, but that was true no matter what. Now, if they attack with both, I eat the Knoll Hunter. If they attack with the Prowler, I just block. And then it comes back, and I can just do it again. Yes, it did. It did work out poorly that I played an island. And if they play a Linorm, then I can. I could bounce it, but then they have access to the spell again. What I might do is just Druidic Ritual back my Linorm, and then play my own Linorm, 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 Linorm. Also, if they attack with both, I block. And this comes back. That doesn't quite work. I have to block the. If they attack with both, I have to block Knoll Hunter. Oh, I kind of like that. I don't mind. They get to draw their card. Okay, so they're going to play Linorm, I'm sure. Well, I drew another blue thing. So, I guess. I'm going to attack. I mean, they get their Shambling Ghast back, but what am I going to do? Like, if they have a removal spell, I lose, but. I'm at 3, and I can't really just sit around doing nothing, right? Jeez, okay. What can they get back? They can get back Viconia. All right, now would be a good time to draw something, anything. Can put a Dread Linorm into play, but Viconia kills me if they draw a swamp. Well, no, not quite, because they have to still activate this. I guess I start with Druidic Ritual. Okay. Yeah, I mean, I'm probably gonna get back the Hill Giant, but all right. Gorgeous George here. Six. Guess I can't really attack, can I? Okay, so they can get back Viconia now, and they probably have access to the green or black version. Unfortunately, those are both really good. I basically have a turn to draw my second band together. I mean, I'm not just dead. Playing the island and not being able to discard forest really did cost me with Lucamino, though, because I would have a young blue dragon in hand instead, which would be a lot better. Yeah, we do have the gate. I'm going to use that next turn. I didn't have enough mana to use it this turn. Blue Lucamina is very good, yes. I mean, one of the advantages of playing more islands is I get to do that. I didn't really specialize means you do have to think about those things. I didn't quite get there. Okay. Hey, what's up, man? Okay. No, they're not just going to put the Linorm into play. Oh, okay. That gives me way more of a chance. That just trades for that. That's not. All right. I drew the band together anyway, but wow. Ooh. Kaga, huh? Guess I'm just gonna pass. I mean, I could band together on the Linorm, but they have Armor of Shadows in their deck, and I don't really think I have a need to do this right now. It's possible that they like make an ill-advised attack or something, or they like try to kill the Hill Giant. I think I'm just gonna block and let them do that. I'm gonna keep this for specialize. I mean, maybe I should have kept the black one, I guess. Okay. Well, they don't have Armor of Shadows. I am actually just gonna do this. Okay, draw. Whew, okay. Let's do that, shall we? You want to see something busted? Let's specialize. Discard this. Oh, we're not going to legend rule ourselves. That's actually not how Viconia works. Because these now have different names. I just need to not flip this one into the green one. Oh, I guess I actually should have just put this into play. I was too excited. Sure, they can play. They can have a lot of Hill Giant Herd Gorgers. It's not gonna get them there. If they want to trade here, that's fine. So I guess the Linorm is probably the thing I'm looking at. All right. And I actually think I'm gonna say cast down in case I draw a blue here. I've got a couple islands left in my deck, right? Yeah. That's a forest. All right. That's not what I wanted so much. I could turn this into the black version. So I guess I don't really care about the Archdruid that much. So what would I want? I could get... we have used the gate, yes. They're at 22. I'm at 6. I mean, and they have 3-3, 3-3, 4-4, 2-7-6. I still kind of have to watch out a little bit. So this is green. So if I turn this into black, I could get a Dreadlin Arm back. Let's attack this. I think I'm just going to do that. And I think I just keep it in hand. It means they can't play a removal spell. And do I have any ways to get back Viconia? I already used Druidic Ritual. I guess Kaga, no, it doesn't even matter because this comes back flipped. So I don't have any reason not to just exile their whole graveyard. Is it worth chump attacking with Lucamina? At some point it might be, yes. Oh, really? I mean, I like this. All right. Let's go Lucamina plus Viconia and Hill Giant Herd Gorger here. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm going to go Dread Lenorm on the Hill Giant, so they're going to kill Viconia. Sure. They still have this. I mean, I guess they can sack Ghast if they want to sack Ghast to do that. Okay, sure. Do you still trade? I mean, this still seems really good for me. Yeah, if they have removal in response to Lenorm, I wouldn't be happy about it, but what are you going to do, right? And I still have a Viconia out, so I don't need to use this one. I mean, this board is looking pretty good for me. They did just draw two cards, so I do have to worry about that. 4, 6, Manticore. Oh, they just shouldn't have played that. This is worse for them, I think. Now this is just going to come back better. Bigger, better, stronger. Unless they have a way to kill it now, of course. Which they probably don't. Ooh, this is exciting. Now, the fact that they knew we had the Lenorm, I wanted to cast it, because I really want to cast this card. It didn't feel too risky to me. Yeah, I'm going to put the Emerald Dragon into play here. I'm going to have two blockers. What's our record? We're 2-0. Might as well activate this because that way I can keep up graveyard exiling. 2-0 in the draft, 1-0 in games. Even one kill spell is not enough to get me to stop me. And if they had a kill spell, they would have used it on Lucamina last turn or crazy. Yeah, sure, that's not going to do anything. Unless they have some ridiculous dragon that we haven't seen, you know, that they haven't shown us. Unfortunately, I don't believe... Can someone... clarify this with me that the next draft, I can't just draft right away. Starts at noon. That is unfortunate. So they're at 10. I have this thing. So this has trample. So they're basically at 5 off of this. This blocks that. They go to 4. And this drains, yeah. They all trample. This was a great game. Will I stream the second draft? That I can't guarantee. If I could have done it right now, I probably would have, but I've already asking a lot of Gabby to tank the Sentinel aggro right now. So turns out having a 10-month-old in the house makes streaming a little bit more challenging. It's funny, you'd think it'd be the opposite. Good match. No, I don't think their deck was very good. I don't think ours was either. I think both these decks are just like black green mid without, like, I had Luka Mina and Viconia. They had Viconia. Like, we both had some fine cards, but like Manicores, whatever, you know. I'm splashing a bunch of young blue dragons, or I guess I sideboarded into like blue green base, but they also have no removal, which it's really hard for your deck to be good if you have no removal. Does Gabby still stream? Well, let's just say if you catch a Gabby stream, you're very lucky. Oh, and there we go. So 3-0 in draft one of the Arena Open. Quite a deck. Let's see. That's a nice super crown. All right, I want to see. Look at the masterpiece we 3-0'd with. Yeah, this was a deck. What do we got? We've got, I mean, we have Viconia and Luka Mina as busted cards. We have two Band Togethers and a Grim Bounty and a cast down, so we have some removal. Really a little bit choked on low drops with only 4 2 mana plays. Do have Lurking Roper and Myconid on 3, but even a lot of my 3s don't even do anything. And Monster Manual was absurdly good for me here. Like it ended up playing really, really well. So, oh, we'll take it. All right, that'll do it for this video, of course. Thanks to Ultimate Guard for sponsoring Team CFB. And of course, check out tcgplayer.com. TCG Player is the marketplace that you should go to for all your card needs. And, you know, we're really happy that TCG Player acquired ChannelFireball. It's been a great partnership. So, thanks for watching, and I will catch you next time. Thank you.